She knows me best like this. In fact, Victoria, you know me best like this, and I wouldn't have it any other way. I am so in love with you, and I am so happy to marry you again. And I cannot wait for the rest of our lives. You have made me feel like a man should, and you have brought love into my life. And again, I just can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you. Guys, I'd like to thank you for being here. It's been a crazy little road. Jason, my best man, you've been through a lot with me. And I know you've been through this whole thing by my side the entire way. So I love you, brother, and thank you for being here. Ben, you're my big man. So I really appreciate you being part of this, and I feel loved and supported by everything that you do for me, and I wouldn't have it any other way, so I appreciate it. And MJ, my man, so I can't thank you enough. I really do love you, I respect you, and I truly appreciate you being here, and I look forward to the future for all of us.
Yeah.
So thank you, guys.
Bring it in, brother.
It's today. We're finally here. Over almost a year of planning, through every up and down, I can honestly say that I am beyond ready to just take on this adventure with you. You are my everything. You are the person that I look to as my pillar. You're the person that I look to as my rock. You are my person, my fuzzball. I love you every part of me, and I cannot wait to embark on this amazing, incredible journey with you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. Your current wife and your future wife. I'll see you at the altar. Hey, Dad. I can only imagine you up there right now. And it makes me so happy that I know how much you love Greg. I want you to know that he loves and treats me like everything that I know that you wish I had found in somebody.
I want you to know that I love you. And that I will always be your little girl. To Mami Tuita and Bobby Jackson, God, y'all would love him. The way he laughs and smiles and loves life. Daddy gets his jokes, and I swear I just hear you. To Uncle Ben, I miss each of you. Every part of every day. I wish y'all were here with us, but I know that you would be if heaven wasn't so far away. I'll carry you guys with me in every moment of this. Every step that I take, Dad, know that Nolan is right there. And he and Mom are gonna give me away today. I love you. You're a little girl.
We welcome all of you here today as we have gathered together in the presence of God and these witnesses to join Greg Lampkin and Victoria McLean in holy matrimony. Marriage is a gift from God given to us so that we might experience the joys of unconditional love with a lifelong partner. God designed marriage to be an intimate relationship between a man and woman, mentally, emotionally, physically and spiritually. And he created men and women with different strengths and needs so that they would complement each other. So each would learn how to give more unselfishly, to grow more fully, and to love more deeply. Now, just as the two of you will make vows to one another today, God also made vows to you and me to show how much he loves and cares for each of us. In the Bible, he said, I will betroth you to myself forever in lawful wedlock with unfailing devotion and love. I will commit myself to you to have and to hold, and you shall know the Lord. Greg and Victoria, you stand here before this loving community of family and friends, ready to say to God and to the world, this is my beloved, the one with whom I choose to share the rest of my days. Now, because your love for each other comes from God, this is a sacred moment, and it is with great honor that I ask you to declare your intent. Greg, are you now prepared to have Victoria to be your wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? And do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to her for as long as you live?
Yes.
It's the right answer. Victoria, are you now prepared to have Greg to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy estate of matrimony? And do you promise to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Perfect. Now, who presents Victoria tonight to be married to Greg?
Her mother and I.
Perfect. Step up, shake his hand.
It's all yours, mother.
Greg and Victoria, today is the beginning of a new life for you two. It marks the commencement of new relationships to your families, to your friends, certainly to each other. You have invited these special guests to share in one of life's greatest moments as they give recognition to the worth and the beauty of your love and their best wishes to the words that shall unite you today as husband and wife. God knew your needs when He brought you two together. He knew exactly what you needed to make you complete. And now He wants you to commit yourselves to each other as the one that He has chosen to complete you. God created the institution of marriage because He knew how much we needed each other. He knew we needed a companion and a helpmate to share our lives. God said, "It's not good for man to be alone. I will make a companion for him, one that fits him perfectly." And so the Lord God caused man to fall into a deep sleep. And while he was sleeping, He took one of the man's ribs and then closed up the place with flesh. And then the Lord God formed a woman from the rib He had taken out of man and brought her to him. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, for she was taken out of man." Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is a very misunderstood passage from the book of Genesis, the second chapter. So I'd like to clarify this for you just a little bit. I want you to notice that woman was made from the rib out of the side of man. She was not created from man's head so that she could rule over him, nor was she created from his feet to be trampled upon by him. Instead, and notice this, woman was taken from his side to be equal to him, from under his arm to be protected by him, and from near his heart to be loved by him. Greg, God's word tells us what kind of husband a man should be for his wife, and I'd like you to listen to this carefully. In the Bible it says, "And you husbands, show the same kind of love to your wives as Christ showed to the church when he died for her." And this is how husbands should treat their wives, loving them in the same kind of way as part of themselves. For since a man and his wife are now one, a man is really doing himself a favor when he loves his wife. No one hates his own body, but lovingly cares for it, just as Christ cares for his body, the church, of which we are all parts. Husbands, live with your wives in an understanding way, giving them respect and showing them honor, since they are heirs together with you from the grace of life. This was taken from Ephesians and 1 Peter. Victoria, the qualities that make a woman truly beautiful are written for us in the book of Proverbs. And there it says, "If you can find a truly good wife, she is worth more than precious gems. Her husband can trust her, and she will richly satisfy his needs. She will not hinder him, but help him all her life. She is a woman of strength and of dignity. She has no fear of old age. When she speaks, her words are wise, and the kindness is the rule of everything she says. She watches carefully all that goes on throughout her household. Her children will stand and bless her, and so does her husband. He praises her with these words, 'There are many fine women in the world, but you are the best of them all.' Charm can be deceptive, and beauty does not last, but a woman who fears and reverences God shall be greatly praised." Now, we are commanded in the Bible to love one another, and through the ages, man has tried to define this word love. Poems, songs, books have all been written trying to describe this little word. But the best description of all comes from God Himself, since He is the author of love. In the Bible, 1 Corinthians 13 is known as the love chapter, and it describes the kind of love that you must have in order to live in peace, joy, and harmony with each other. So I'd like you to listen to what it says. Love is patient, kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It's not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist in its own way. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in the wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. And so faith, hope, and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. Now, Greg, for the easy part, here's all you have to do. You just have to repeat after me and look at her.
I, Greg, take thee, Victoria.
I, Greg, take thee, Victoria.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
And this is my solemn vow.
I, Victoria, take thee, Greg.
I, Victoria, take thee, Greg.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
And this is my solemn.
And this is my solemn. Prayer, right? Did I miss a part?
You did.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm a little nervous.
Sorry. You're doing great.
Now, the wedding ring serves as a symbol of the promises that you two have just spoken. It is the outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible love that binds your two hearts together. The wedding ring is also a symbol of what God is. He is without beginning and without end. He is eternal. And as you'll see, these rings are without beginning and without end, so I believe that this exchange of rings not only reminds us of the unending love that you two have for each other, but it also reflects the eternal love that God has for each of you. Now, may I have the token of Greg's love for Victoria, please? Or you can just give me all the rings. Perfect. Thank you. Now, if you'll take these rings and slip them on her finger right away, and as you slip them on her finger, if you'll please repeat after me.
Got 'em?
Yep.
Victoria, these rings I give in token and pledge.
Victoria, these rings I give in token and in pledge.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
With these rings, I thee wed.
And with these rings, I thee wed.
Perfect. Now, Victoria, if you'll slip this on his trembling finger. And as you slip that on, if you'll please repeat after me. Greg, this ring I give in token and pledge.
Greg, this ring I give in token and in pledge.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
As a sign of my love and devotion.
And with this ring, I thee wed.
And with this ring, I thee wed.
Perfect. Now, when a couple marries, it is not just the joining together of two lives, but the coming together of two families as well. This is especially true today, for as Greg and Victoria become husband and wife, they are also joined by Branson, Isabella, and Braden to become a family. And at this time, we'd like to recognize these young gentlemen and this young lady, and acknowledge their significance on the wedding day. Now, as this beautiful family joins their hands here, I would ask Greg that you and Victoria please repeat after me together. Today, as we become husband and wife,
today, as we become husband and wife,
we welcome you into our new family.
We welcome you into
We recognize that you are a precious gift from God.
We recognize that you are a precious gift from God.
And we promise to be there for you always.
We promise to be with you.
For you always?
Yes. To comfort you and care for you.
To comfort you and care for you.
To protect and provide for you.
To protect and provide for you.
To guide you and to listen to you.
To guide you and to listen to you.
And most of all.
And most of all.
To love you with all our hearts.
To love you with all our hearts.
All the days of your lives.
All the days of your lives.
Perfect. What a beautiful family.
Perfect. What a beautiful family.
That was my line. Okay, you guys can go and sit down.
How long is your dress?
That's a long dress.
You like it?
No, don't step on it,
honey. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hand fasting is an ancient Celtic word for wedding. It was recognized as a binding contract of marriage between a man and woman before the church or the government became involved in weddings. After the wedding vows, or in those ancient times, the gift exchange and the ring exchange, the couple's hands were actually bound with a cord that was tied in a love knot. And this is how the term tying the knot actually came to be. Now today, hand fasting is a symbolic ceremony to honor a couple's desire for commitment to each other and to acknowledge that their lives and their destinies are now bound together. Now Greg, if you will extend your hands, palms up. And Victoria, if you will extend your hands, palms up, resting in his. In ancient times, Greg, this was so you could see the precious gift that Victoria is to you. Now, this cord, or this length of leather, is a symbol of the life that you two have chosen to live together. Up until this time, you have been separate in thought, separate in word, and separate in deed, but now, as this cord is tied together, so shall your lives become intertwined. And with this cord, I will bind you to the vows you have made to one another. And with a knot that I will tie you heart to heart, together as one. How you doing? You okay?
How are you?
You're perfect.
Okay.
You are right.
Double knot.
All right, now I'm tying this knot really tight, so don't undo it.
Okay.
Well, you guys just sit right here for a second. This love knot that we have tied in this cord is not the strength that will hold your marriage together, but as always, you hold in your hands the making or breaking of this union. May this love knot always be a reminder of the binding together of your two hands, your two hearts, and your two souls into one. And so you are bound to each other for all the days of your lives. Now, if you'll just stand there for a moment, holding hands, which is as it should be, I'd like to read this beautiful poem entitled, These Hands. These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love, that hold yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other all the days of your life. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you build your future together. These are the hands that will passionately love you and care for you throughout the years. These are the hands that will hold you when fear and grief fill your mind, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will give you strength when you struggle, and support and encouragement to chase down your dreams. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children and help keep your family together as one. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, the tears of sorrow and the tears of joy. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled with age, will still be reaching for yours still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch from these hands. Now would everyone bow your heads for prayer, please. Our Heavenly Father, we're asking your blessing upon Greg and Victoria and the home they're establishing here today. And may the love that they have for each other grow deeper and stronger because of their love for you. Lord, you've guided them to each other. And now we ask that you guide them in this new journey as husband and wife. And as they walk down this path, light their way so that they may keep their eyes clearly focused on your will, their hands holding fast to your truth, their feet firmly planted in your word, and their hearts bound together by your precious love. And this we ask in your holy name. Amen. Well, today, since you two have consented together in holy matrimony, and we have pledged yourselves to each other by your solemn vows and by the giving and receiving of rings, you've declared your commitment of love before God and all of these witnesses. I now bestow upon you the most honorable titles that may exist between a man and woman. I now pronounce you husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together, let no man separate. So now, Greg, I believe we've come to the moment that we have all been patiently and warmly waiting for. You may kiss your lovely bride. Well done. May she have her bouquet back. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to introduce to you, hang on there, big guy. For the first time, or the second time, actually.
Actually, thank you.
As husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Greg Lampkin.
Come on, Isabella.
You like the song I picked?
I do. I love it, James. We did.
I talked to mom this morning. She's like, this is a concert she took me to when I was three.
Three?
Yes.
Give me a kiss.
Nobody but you for all my life. When you're with me, baby, the skies are blue.
Say a message to your mom?
Yeah, what do you want to say to your mom?
Your chin a little forward. Good. And slide your down.
Every time I'm left behind me.
tubbies. All the hell I've called. All the lips I've kissed. All the love I've owed. I thank God for that. I guess he always knew I was on my way to you.
Throughout the years, Victoria has been a true inspiration to me. I knew right away that we'd be best friends. Victoria, you're the hardest worker and most driven person I know. She's an amazing mother and truly has the biggest heart of anyone I've ever met. That's why when she met Greg, I was beyond excited. Greg, you have the biggest heart. You are not only a friend of the family, but you're now officially family. After their very first date, Victoria called me and told me that she had met the one. And guess what, Victoria? You were right. You have met your soulmate. And I know this because I have never seen you happier. I am so grateful that you both have found each other, and I'm beyond grateful to finally celebrate this day with you. Cheers and congratulations to the Mr. and Mrs. Yeah.
Thank you, Griffin.
I love you.
Speech. I was actually told I wasn't gonna have to give a speech, so I have nothing prepared like someone who writes her stuff down.
Spoiler highlight.
Yeah, but I've known Greg a lot of years, and he's the most loving person you'll ever know. And I really love the fact that he finally found someone that treats him the way he deserves to be treated. And so, like, Seeing him the way he was today and the way, like, he looks at Victoria every day makes me get goosebumps. I love it. I love that he's, and not that he treats Victoria the way she wants to be treated. They're perfect for each other. And so I am so happy that you guys found each other and are going to spend the rest of your life together.
I love you guys.
We love you.
I'm not afraid. Why don't you come to see?
of a family with me and MJ. We're raising these little baseball kids. We love them. We're going to think the world. We asked them to join us. This guy is amazing. He has integrity. He's true to everything he does. He's an amazing man. He is just, or as Jason would say, he's a dick. But realistically, this guy is an amazing person.
Okay.
And they're meant for one another. And all you people here are amazing. So let's get the glass and let's go party our asses off. And have a good time for these two people.
I don't know if the brightest will stay here, but I feel very moved in this moment just because of A, it is so hot. So thank you to every individual here right now who is going through this because we are all sweating unbelievably. But most importantly, growing up, girls dream of I guess, their wedding, or girls dream of their kind of fairy tale romance. And I never could have dreamed in a million years or wished or hoped or prayed for somebody, and Lord knows I prayed. Because I never knew somebody like you existed. In fact, I was so shut off from meeting somebody when Greg first approached me, and I realized that when I allowed myself to let love in, God gave me the greatest blessing. And I'm so unbelievably happy that every single one of you is here sharing this moment with us. It means more to us than I think I can even put into words. I am so excited to start our future together. I guess renew our vows is what I've kind of been saying. But truly, thank you so much, each and every one of you. I love this man more than I can even describe to you guys, and I'm so excited to begin our love story. Each of you who know us and kind of know our journey know how much we love each other, and I'm so excited to have that love grow. And I just want to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart because it just means a lot. Mm-hmm. We love you.
Mamacita, you know how much you mean to us, and this couldn't happen without you.
To Mamacita! To Mamacita! Que bonita!
Mamacita!
So we're gonna go inside and change.
I'm pretty sure Jill's only bank taking a
look at
it.
She said, can I dip her?
Stop.
You can jump.
You gotta get the camera.
Yeah. We gotta get. You're rubbing into my eyes.
We'll be right back.
the sound.